Hello, space fans, and welcome to Your Sky Tonight. My name is Tony Darnell from deepastronomy.space. Tonight, we are going to cast our gaze on this mid-November evening towards the west. If you go out at dusk, just as the sun dips below the horizon, you'll immediately see two bright dots that aren't twinkling. Remember from past episodes that one way you can tell if you're looking at a bright star or a planet is by whether it's twinkling or not? Planets do not twinkle, and stars do. Planets, while they may look like dots in the sky, are actually not points of light like very distant stars. Planets are close enough to us to actually appear round, and this makes the area of light reflected from them larger than the turbulence in the atmosphere, holding them steady. So, just after the sun goes down, look west. The mighty Saturn is very easy to see, and just below it, another slightly dimmer light. That dot is the planet Mercury, and you have to catch it just after sunset or you'll miss it. You'll also miss it if you have high trees or buildings on your western horizon, because it will be very low. We can only see the planets Mercury and Venus in the early morning or early evening hours. Venus is so bright that we often call it the evening or the morning star, depending on when it's visible. Those two planets are inside the orbit of the Earth, and so to see them, we have to look towards the sun, and most of the time, they are obscured from our view because of the overwhelming brightness of the sun. But at certain times in their orbits, they are visible to us, and here's why. This is a view of our inner solar system as it appears tonight. Imagine if we could launch ourselves into space and look above the Earth towards the sun. Here, you can see the positions of the inner planets as they are tonight in mid-November. This is the orbit of Mercury, and as you can tell, it's approaching an orientation that from our perspective makes it visible in our early evening sky. It still has a little way to go, however. It will reach its most favorable position in our night sky in a few more days, around November 25th. And right about here, it will start to go down in our sky. What will that look like to us? If we go out every night at dusk and look low in the west, each night Mercury will get higher and higher in our early evening sky and reach an apex about here, around the 25th or so, when it will then start to descend towards the horizon as it passes the best vantage point for us to see it in its orbit. While we're talking about the inner planets, what about Venus? Well, here is its orientation with respect to the Earth. It is on the other side of the Sun compared to Mercury, and we should expect to see it in the early morning hours here on Earth. Does that happen? Sure enough, if you go out just before sunrise, there it is, the morning star heralding in the dawn of a new day. Well, that's it for this episode, space fans. I hope you'll go out at dusk or at dawn to try and catch a glimpse of the two innermost planets in our solar system. The rest of this month should be pretty good for checking out Mercury and Venus. Thank you all for listening, and as always, keep looking up. Deep Astronomy is sponsored by The Great Courses Plus, a subscription on-demand video learning service where space fans can enjoy lectures in astronomy from top professors from around the world. I particularly recommend Exoplanets, What Astronomers Know by Dr. Joshua Wynn. Go to thegreatcoursesplus.com/deepastronomy to get a free one-month trial to check out all the great stuff they have. And you can support Deep Astronomy by getting a subscription. I think space fans everywhere will get a lot out of their courses.